This is the second date update on the 10th with Ramiro, Pebbles, and Melissa. The Get Up Crew.
Hot 96.9.
So, Scott, you're looking for a girl by the name of Nella? Is that it?
Yeah, I'm looking for Nella.
Okay, well, what happened? Talk to us. How'd you f*** up?
Great.
No, so we've been seeing each other for a bit, you know, and I thought we got along real well, and, you know, we had a bunch in common, and the last time we hung out was at her sister's house, and now she's not getting back to me. You know, I'm not really sure what happened, but the only thing I could think of is that when we left her sister's house, I asked if I could crash at her place because it was late. Her place is closer to my work.
Yeah.
So, you know, I thought that was it. She let me, but she did seem a little annoyed about it. And, like, we didn't even have sex or anything, right? Like, I slept on her couch.
Yeah. She allots a certain amount of time that she can stand you, and anything over that time is like, nah. Now he gets annoying. She's like, he's only good for like 6 to 8 hours. Did anything happen at her sister's house?
No, man. Like, I can't think of anything like off the top of my head that was like crazy.
Okay.
You know?
So clearly it's obvious. She was like, why are you sleeping on the couch? I want some of that sweet d-. And you were like, listen, honey, I got to go to bed. I got to go to work in the morning. Not tonight. I have a headache. Yeah. We'll be like, hey, listen, he's going to go over and f*** you hard tonight.
Okay.
Okay. Stay quiet, Scott. We're going to call her right now.
All right.
Hello?
Hi, is this Nella?
This is Nella.
Okay, perfect. Nella, my name's Ramiro. I'm here with Pebbles and Melissa. We're calling you from Hot 96.9, the radio.
Wait, what?
So,
who the f*** are you?
Okay, wow. We're calling you from a radio station, but I can explain. We got your phone number from a gentleman who wanted us to reach out to you. Can I explain real quickly?
Wait, hold on. I mean, you know this sounds real weird right now, right?
Yes, it does, but it'll make sense when I tell you the guy's name, okay? So it's a guy that you know, and he wanted us to reach out to you to ask you out for a date on his behalf. And I'm going to tell you his name, but first, well, let me tell you why we're calling you. If you say yes to this date, we're going to let you pick the restaurant that you can go to. We're going to let you pick the day, the time, all that stuff, and we will pay for the food. We will pay for the drink. We'll pay for everything. Just you and this guy having a free date. Worst case scenario, you and him.
Somebody I want to see. Who is it?
Okay. I think you do want to see him because you were hanging out with him before, and he's a little confused as to why you're not hanging out now. His name is Scott. Now he.
Oh hell! I was hoping it wasn't him that you were talking about.
Well, hold on.
Oh my god!
He's sorry for what he did to your couch. If there's anything that he. No, well, he said that he stayed over your house last time because he had to go.
He had to go to work.
So
annoying.
He's confused as to why you're not.
I don't really be surprised as well, and I like to know how my night is being planned, how my day is being planned. Mm-hmm. And what turned me off the get-go is that he wanted to sleep over my house. But I let him, but it was still annoying.
Yeah. So that's it? Because he wants to sleep over your house?
I mean, if I'm going to get straight to it, the brother hates babies, and I can't see myself with someone like that.
He hates
what?
What do you mean I hate babies?
What?
Wait, hold on. Wait, one second.
What's going on here?
Okay, Nella, Scott is on the phone. He's listening to what you're saying. But hold on. I don't understand. You said he hates babies?
Yes.
We went on like 4 dates and you're already talking about having kids?
Yeah.
No, you piece of but when I saw how you were handling my nephew, the signs were there.
What?
Okay, so my sister just had a baby. We went to go visit the baby. Scott and I, we've been hanging out for a bit. So, you know, as any relationship we maneuver on, it goes down to the family.
Yeah.
Me opening myself up, letting you into my family, I bring you over to my sister's house, and you're acting like the baby is some sort of disease.
What? What do you mean?
Basically, he was acting like he didn't want to touch the baby. And here's the thing. We're at the house. Of course, my little baby, his name is Jeremy.
Uh-huh.
Jeremy is now welcome into the world. As we're having a moment, we pass him the baby around just to say, hey, you know. And when it comes down to when he has to hold the baby, he looked at me dead in the eye and said, no thanks. I don't like holding babies. Like, what the f***?
Okay.
This is my nephew.
Defend him here. I'm the same way only because I get nervous that, you know, I haven't had a lot of experience holding babies, so I would rather not. I'd rather keep the baby alive.
She almost dropped my baby.
Yes. So I can defend that.
It's so awkward, though. He's sitting there, and I'm hearing him yell, "I don't want to hold it." And at one point, my nephew just starts crying, like, "What?
Why? Can I defend myself now?"
Yes.
Hold on, Scott. You were yelling, "I don't want to hold the baby."
look,
weird.
Like. My younger brother, right? He's 14 years younger than me. And when I was a kid, I accidentally dropped him, and everyone freaked out. Like, everybody thought he was going to die.
Wait, like, hold on. You dropped your brother?
He dropped his brother.
So you're 14 years old. You go to hold your baby brother, and you drop him.
Yeah, and it's scarred me for life.
And what, like...
I would say so,
was he
yeah.
okay?
I mean, you know, he can hold the job for the most part. You know, he's a little socially awkward, but I mean, overall, he's okay.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
So, when you say you dropped your baby brother, can you explain the situation?
When I was 14, like, my baby brother, he's starting to cry, and my mom's like, "Hey, could you go grab him?" You know, and so I go, and he's in the crib, and I pick him up, and he starts squirming, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I freak out. And I let him go. And he hits the chair, and then he hits the floor. And, like, then my entire family, like, rushes in. They, like, shove me out of the way. Like, they pick him up. My mom's like, "You're a dumb piece of shit." Like, it's a really traumatic experience, man. Like, no, look, man. Like, everybody's got a thing that they can't do. And mine is holding babies.
Oh, my God. This is f***ing crazy. Like, this is f***ing bullshit. After 18 years, you feel like you are not capable of holding a child. What does that say? If you're dating me, if we have a child, let's just say the diaper needs to be changed and I have a broken arm. What are you going to do, Scott? What is animal? Can I pass you the baby or do I have to take the baby into the bathroom?
Like, okay, so wait. So if you break your arm, if we have a kid, if your legs are broken, if, like, I'm in a hot air balloon and then I need to fly down and pick up the kid, that's what you're asking me.
I love the fact that Scott saying no thank you to holding the baby turned into Nella picturing their life together. Mm. I think we can solve this. We set up another dinner with you guys before you go to the restaurant. You go to Nella's sister's house. Scott, you show that you can hold a baby for about 30 seconds to a minute. And then you guys go have a good dinner. And then, you know, you get married and have many children. And Nella, you can break your arm.
No.
That's a no? Scott?
No. Like, I get, I mean, if she's not into it, like, f*** it, I'm not into it either.
You know? Don't do you, ass.
The second date update on the 10th.
Weekday mornings at 6:10, 7:10, and 8:10.
If you need a second date update, email us. GetUpCrew@hot969boston.com.
That's all there is to it.